투자에 대한 게 하나 더 나왔네요. 루스란 미카일로브 트레이딩진 마케팅 총괄께서 오늘 발표를 해주시겠습니다. 예, 박수로 맞이해 주시기 바랍니다.
Dear ladies and gentlemen, my name is Ruslan. Today I'm going to tell you about TradingGene company. And I'm going to tell you about the evolution. Today, a lot of ICO projects use the word revolution. And we use the word evolution for purpose. We would like to show you that we're not going to forget about the base that we have, about the financial base that was created during all this time, but we're going to move it one step forward. And I'd like to start my presentation with the snow leopard. And this is a really beautiful, rare, and endangered animal. There are just 100 of species left. And today it's really hard to find one. And this is a profitable algorithm that actually much more harder to find on the market today than even a snow leopard. And by profitable algorithm, I mean the trading robot that actually trades without manual intervention, without a person. And where you can actually meet it? You can meet it in Bridgewater or Two Sigma. This is the two biggest hedge funds that use algorithmic trading, and they earn a lot of money with it. Maybe soon you can find it in Goldman Sachs that actually fired last year 600 traders and hired 200 computer engineers instead to develop trading algorithms. So today, only big institutional investors and experienced traders use algorithmic trading. But if we consider the alternatives, on the one hand, we have an asset manager. An asset manager actually shows no consistent result. And the asset manager has high management fees because they prefer private jets and big mansions in New York. They actually can be affected with emotions. And emotions are by far a serial killer of even the profitable traders. And still, asset managers became the most popular financial instrument. And I'm talking about exchange-traded funds right now. So how come that a person that doesn't show consistent result became a popular financial instrument, while we have a trading algorithm that actually shows consistent results since 1971, since the year they were invented, that actually has much lower management fees, that cannot be affected by emotions, and that hasn't become a financial instrument at all? You cannot go to the market today and simply purchase a profitable trading algorithm. So, in fact, those who use trading algorithms account only for the minor part of the market. And that's actually, the retail investors represent more than 10 times. But despite the potential of the product, of the trading algorithm, there's also a big problem. And the problem actually goes down to one particular question. How can you offer an algorithm to the public? So the first thing you can do is actually to sell it. And this will done the same thing that actually MP3, you know, did to music. It's gonna kill it. The other option is that you can accumulate investors' funds on a creator's account. But that actually makes the algorithm creators a fund. And being a fund actually means that you need to go through a lot of legal, reputational, and organizational issues. It's a long and tough way to go. The other way you can do it is to transmit signals. And by transmitting signals, I mean that all the trades are actually done on investors' accounts. And you can do it in two ways. The first one, the easiest one, is actually a subscription-based. The subscription-based method is actually when investor pay a fixed amount of money prior he connect his account to an algorithm. And this method actually demotivates developers from providing a high-quality algorithm because they don't care how algorithm is going to work. What they care about is the fixed money they receive prior selling their algorithm. So what they do is actually create something that looks good in the history and doesn't work in reality. There's also another way how you can do this, and actually you can use success fees. So when the creator gets the percentage of profit. And this is certainly the best way you can do this. But there is also a problem. No one knows how to do this today. So the problem is as follows. Let's imagine you have 1,000 investors and you transmit signals to their accounts and all of them earn, let's say, just $100. You need to get $10 from all of them. What are you going to do if they refuse to pay? You're not going to sue them because there's a lot of headaches simply because of $10 from every person? No. And actually, a lot of all market participants today decided to use subscription-based model. And because of this, what we see today is inefficiency in capital attraction, inability of people to develop good algorithms, and a big lack of transparency, because you never know whether you're going to purchase a working algorithm or not. And this is what actually Trading Gene is going to fix. So Trading Gene is a platform where anyone can develop their own trading algorithm. The Trading Gene approves that the algorithm works and actually promotes it to investors. So let's consider how it works on a basic scheme. So we have a creator that actually developed a profitable trading algorithm, and we have an investor with his crypto account. So the first thing the developer does is actually programs his trading robot on Trading Gene platform for us to be able to approve that the algorithm is good. Then we actually let investor to choose whether he like it or not. If he does like it, then he makes a deposit on our platform. We connect the algorithm, and as soon as he starts earning money, we actually demand him to increase the deposit for us to make payment to creator. So this gives us an exposure to a market without additional KYC or flow of funds, and this is a tremendous market. And actually, the token economics is really important here, because the first point of how the token is going to be used is to provide a success fee for creators in a platform. And without a token, it's almost impossible to do. Why? Because if you want to get a deposit in fiat money, you need to get a lot of licenses all over the world to hold a deposit of people. And with utility tokens, you don't need to do this. So there is much less legal burden. There is much less bureaucracy behind it. So the next thing the token is going to be used is actually a means of payment for additional services. And the last one is a VIP status to approve VIP status for our ICO investors. And VIP status gives some massive discounts on the company's products. So where we are right now, we actually developed the platform where you can create your algorithms. So it's available online. There's also an educational course which was covered by a lot of people. Right now we actually have 300 creators that developed 2,000 trading algorithms. Here you see some screenshot of the platform that's actively used. We see an increased number of creators every month and every week. And actually, some of their algorithms was already launched on investor accounts. And right now, we cooperate with this investment that have accounts on Bitfinex Exchange to develop some really pleasant platform for people, for investors. What we actually want to do is that we want to get you an opportunity to deliver you an opportunity to be able to invest in trading algorithms with one simple click. So we've actually developed the prototypes, and we're going to release the platform by the July 1st this year. And we actually use Waves, not Ethereum. So this is an interesting point, and I'm asked a lot, why do we prefer using Waves and not Ethereum? So there are several actual things. There is a technology behind it, and there is a business point behind it. So in terms of technology, Waves blockchain is one of the fastest in the world. It's actually one of the cheapest as well. And if you think about the business behind blockchain, blockchain transaction costs a lot. And if you're going to see a lot of transactions, most of your operational profits are going to be decreased, and a lot of ICO projects do not consider this point when using Ethereum. And the last point is actually scalability. And in this respect, I'd like to remember our CryptoKitties back in Ethereum, when Ethereum actually had some problems. So in the business perspective, first of all, it's a support. Let's say you use Ethereum for your tokens and something goes wrong. Okay, let's say you wrote to Vitalik Buterin and asked for help. I really doubt that he's going to reply you. In terms of Waves, we're actually strategic partners of them, and they're based in the same city we're based in, so they're available, and we can, in any moment, in any emergency situation, we can ask for help, and they will help us. And they will not just provide a help, they will provide a competence behind the help, because today we have approximately 5 jobs for every blockchain specialist. So in terms of jobs and blockchain specialists, if ICO project runs their own blockchain or actually use some Ethereum as well, they most likely either have no good specialists or they have a really bad specialist. And this is just the situation the blockchain specialists are lacking. So the last point actually is a cooperation. So we're going to be the first platform where Wave's going to use their smart contract, and we're going to really satisfy all the trading gene needs at the same time developing one of the biggest blockchain community. And in terms of blockchain and how we use it, so we use it mostly to fix the terms between the platform, between the creator and the investor, and also used to make some auctions bid. And by auctions bid, I mean that the price of the algorithm is actually defined on the platform with the market mechanism. So we have an international team with Daniel Wolf, an American who actually founded the biggest investment bank in Russia, and who is actually right now owns his own crypto fund, being our CEO. Our CTO spent more than 8 years in parallels and 20 years in brokerage software development. This bald, handsome guy, Ruslan, that actually stands in front of you, is a world record in terms of CFTA score. So we have a really professional team with a big trading and algorithmic trading background. And actually we have a great team of advisors as well. So Tim Seymour, maybe some of you know him. He's actually runs a fast money program on CNBC every week, and he's one of the hedge fund managers in US. Sasha Ivanov is the head of Waves blockchain, one of the most successful blockchain projects so far. Bruce Kim is the head of one of the biggest payment company in the world, that actually a Kiwi company, NASDAQ listed company. Tomoyo Suzuki is a machine learning expert that won John Brooks Award in 2016. Dan Valko is a trader that actually was for 6 years the chairman of International Federation of Technical Analysis. And Aaron Smith, actually a person who managed $1.5 billion. So this is a funny slide, because actually when I sent a presentation to Cinco, a couple of days passed and I decided to delete it, because I thought that it's meaningless to talk about the seeds of success after all, everything I actually mentioned. So, but once again, we focus on the big market with a really strong team and having some big competitive advantages. And we do not actually depend on crypto. So a couple of minutes ago, actually, approximately 1 hour ago, Anton asked you, do you feel uncomfortable because of the Bitcoin fell? Well, we actually felt good. I mean, our investors felt good because they were not holding Bitcoins. They were actually trading Bitcoins using our algorithms. And this is actually a good time for us, because you don't just buy today, you trade. So our ICO actually starts on May 16th. We're going to distribute 70% of the ICO. And right now we're in a private sales stage with a minimum investment of $5K. But at the same time, what I'd like to point out is that we created, here you see a link for a pre-sales stage in Seoul. But actually we created a special link only for Cinco participants that are actually available in our community manager at the booth outside. So if you want to take a part in participants, the link is going to be available only for 2 days. And once again, I would like to point out that this is a time of evolution. This is the time to create a brand new financial product that's actually a trading algorithm. Thank you.